girl. That is Blümchen, the German singer. Or one of them is a group. So, what impression does she make on you? Huh? Happy. Yes, she is very good. Yeah, she's very good. And we say in German, sie ist gut drauf. She is feeling great. And that is what she says in her song. So let us listen first before we go to the text. I explain to you only shortly, yeah, because we have the time for something else today. So what about the rest of the text? Anything you can pick up from there? So roughly, so overall, when you go through the text like that. Anything? Yes, good, Jason. It's a good start. Okay, Maggie. Mach mein Herz auf. I open my heart. Lass die Sonne rein. Lass die Sonne rein. Sun. Die Sonne ist the sun. Lass die Sonne rein means let the sun in your heart. Jeder Tag soll ein Geschenk und was Besonderes sein. Geschenk, we had already the word. Jeder Tag also. Yeah, every day should be a present and something special. Now here the sein is at the back. Should be, soll sein, should be. Now there are some new words, so I help you a bit with this because we have no other things to do today. Also every day should be a present and something special. Ich stehe auf, ah, that is simple, ja? Alfred? Ich stehe auf. Yes. Schau aus dem Fenster. Fenster is the window. Schau aus dem Fenster. Look out of the window. And what do I see? Ein Himmelblau. Blau? Yeah. Himmel? What you see when you look out of the window? Yeah. The sky. The blue of the sky. Yeah. Blue sky. So nice weather in other words. Eh? Vertrieben sind die Nachtgespenster. Ah, that you like all that hand-to-hand-to stories, right? Gespenster are spirits. Und Nacht, you know already. Nacht. So, that are the spirits of the night, right? Vertrieben means chased away. Yeah, chased away are already the spirits of the night. Und ich weiß genau. And I know exactly, today is my day. Can you imagine the situation? You wake up, you look out of the window, sun is shining, blue sky, you feel good. And yeah, you know exactly, today is my day. So nothing can happen to you today, everything will be fine. Okay, next one. Next, what she is doing after she wake up? Ich schaue in den Spiegel. I look into the mirror. And what do I see there? So first she looked out of the window, right? But now she looks in the mirror. Zieh mir was Besonderes an. Anziehen is a trennbares Verb and means to pull on, to wear, to pull on. So, was Besonderes, we had here already just now, was something special, yeah, she wears something special. Und es ist nicht zu glauben, it is unbelievable, dass man so gut aussehen kann, that one can look so great. So she is happy with her picture in the mirror. And then next, she goes out on the street. Ich tanze auf der Straße. Ich tanze, ja, ich tanze, the E is missing here, everywhere, where is an apostrophe, the E is missing there. Ich tanze auf der Straße, I am dancing on the street. And here I think I have a wrong word, right? It's here lach in the text, lach den Menschen ins Gesicht. That is not stronger than see, yeah? See is only see. But now lach, you have it in your textbook, huh? Lach is laugh at them, laugh at the people, smile at the people. Yeah, the Menschen are the people, ins Gesicht, into the face, so you smile at them. Alles denkt, ich bin verrückt, everybody is thinking I am crazy. Denn sie wissen nicht, because they don't know, today is my day. Only you know how great you are feeling, yeah? But have you ever been in such a situation? Yeah? Samir? Can you remember what happened there? Say again, I didn't get you. When you had such a feeling once already or several times in your life, then do you remember what was it caused for off? Don't know, you just wake up and feel great. Yeah, it's nice, why not? Yes, it's nice. Sometimes like that. Just now the other group, they say, no, we never had that. I say, oh, poor guys. Yeah, you could have such an experience before, Nidhi? Yes. Yes, yeah, it's good to feel so good, right? So, and you can see that also sometimes. And you say here, ich tanze auf der Straße, lach den Menschen ins Gesicht. So you feel happy, you feel great, so you transfer that already to others. So it happened to me, yeah? When I can just tell you a short episode. When I was getting married with my hubby, then I was still in Germany at that time. And then, yeah, my colleagues, they say also, hey, something wrong with you, eh? What happened to you? You look so happy, so great. Yeah, it's, you have it in your aura, yeah? You transfer that feeling to others. And then they also feel happy. To this place where we can find this signboard. So when you have a look on this, there are a lot of words, but also some pictures. What information do we get from there? I help you a little bit to structure this with this small table here. You know, it's a bit blur here with the light. That is here, wann. Wo, essen, trinken und Spaß. Everywhere is there a question mark, so we should find out where is this signboard to be found, what is happening there, when, do we eat there, what could we eat, what could we drink there, and where is the fun, some fun. So have a closer look into the text and try to fill in this little table here. Just a short brainstorm what is here going on, that we are in the right picture afterwards. The dot is in English, the TH. Ah! So, lampu menyala. So, when this is the TH, then it is the first of May, also ST in this case, yeah. The first of May, der erste fünfte auf Deutsch. Ersten fünften. Am ersten fünften. So, that is am, in other words, am ersten Mai. Am 1. Mai. So, um 15 Uhr. Um 15 Uhr. So, was ist da? Was ist at this time? Was gibt es da? pretty. Say it loud. Huh? Yeah, that is 3 o'clock. It's Nachmittag. Of course, I ask you, what is there happening at this time, at this date, at this time? So, what is Eröffnung and what is Eis und Spaß? Was ist das? Eröffnung, let us start at the beginning. Eröffnung means what? Opening, yeah. New opening. So it should be, what do you think, what is it? A shop, yes. And something with ice, right? So maybe an ice cream shop. No? Eine neuen Eisdiele. Also the opening of a new ice cream shop. Ice Café. Ja? Wie heißt die Eisdiele?
Eis und Spaß.
Ja, Eis und Spaß. That means Eis and Fun. Ja, so now we are figure out what is the Spaß at this Eisdiele? Musik, ja, Sie können Musik hören. Ja, so you can fill in here Musik hören. Im Internet surfen, ja, make it to a phrase. Okay. Und you can have a small talk, right? You can have chat with your friends, a conversation. Okay, wo ist das? Wo ist die Eisdiele? Wo ist die Eisdiele? Wo? Ja? In Linz. Ja, also postcode, no need now to read this. But im Donauweg, that is die Straße. Ja, die Straße. Number 23. In Linz. Ist Linz in Deutschland Donauweg? Donau is the river Danube, ja? The blue Danube, maybe the walls, you have heard about that, von Johann Strauss. But Donau is a river, and we have here, may I just show you? The river, sorry, no, is starting in the Black Forest and goes here all the way up to Regensburg and then down here to Linz and then long way in the Black Sea until the Black Sea, like here in the east. Yeah? So, Linz is here. So, is that Deutschland? Daddy says yes. What says those who can see better here, the nearer sitting one? Is there any border? Is any Grenze there around? You remember the one of the first lesson I showed you, where is the border of Germany? What are the countries, neighbor states? Yeah. So? Czech Republic. Can you show the Czech Republic, Jason? Ah, that is the Czech Republic here, this part. So, Linz is here. Österreich, yeah. Österreich, you can pronounce that in the meanwhile? Or is it still the ostrich? No, it's Österreich, right? Österreich, yeah. Correct. So, Linz is right, a very unusual part of Österreich, because when you think of Österreich, you think of the mountains, right? Same as Switzerland. But here it is quite flat. Huh? So there is also a bit more industry in that area there. But never mind, they also have an ice cafe. Okay, so that is already here, Österreich. Okay, which questions we have still to answer? Essen und trinken. We don't know that yet. We don't have the picture. Oh, here maybe ice cream and Kuchen. Yes. So, what is only today? You, so Pandai, always using your digital dictionary. What about today? Free, yes, gratis is percuma, free. So what is free? The Spaß, the conversation, the internet, or what is free? Fun food, eine Speise. One food and or not and. Be careful with the words. Or one drink. Yes. So, yeah, let's go. Make a trip to Linz. So, what they have there? Here, this one maybe noch we have to check. Komm mit deinen Freunden zu Eisen Spaß. Ein echt tolles Erlebnis. Yes, a real great experience. Ein tolles Erlebnis. So that must be something really great. Eh? So we have to have a look. So what do they have? Was gibt es dort? Was gibt es bei Eis und Spaß? So, did you have lunch already? No. So, can you identify an order? Die Cola is what? This one. Okay. Die Cola. Das Eis. This one?
No.
This one? Did you say no? Ein vehementes no. What? Which one is the ice coffee? Links. Ah, sorry, der Kuchen, I have here first. Never mind. Der Kuchen, then? Der Eiskaffee. Ja? Ja? Zitronentee, ja, that is a lemon here, right? In your heart. Und? Schinkenkäse Toast. Was ist Schinkenkäse? Something cheese. What is normally connected with the cheese in the toast? Ham, exactly. So Schinkenkäse is ham and cheese toast. And then is there noch ein Mineralwasser. That one. Das Mineralwasser, ja, das Mineralwasser, not mineral water, Mineralwasser. Okay, let's see, das Eis, can you repeat?
Das Eis.
Der Kuchen.
Der Kuchen.
Das Mineralwasser.
Das Mineralwasser.
Die Cola.
Die Cola.
Der Schinkenkäse-Toast.
Der Schinkenkäse-Toast.
Der Zitronentee.
Der Zitronentee.
Tee. This are zwei E's. Two E's, not E's, okay? Zwei E's, ja? Der Zitronentee.
Der Zitronentee.
Ah, ja. Und?
Der Eiskaffee.
Ja, Kaffee. Freddy, was möchten Sie?
Ich möchte das Eis.
Alright, so when you order, then you say das Eis oder which, what do you say?
Ein Eis.
Yeah. Ich möchte ein Eis. Alright. Was möchten Sie, Lalita? Make a whole sentence, please. Damir? What's up? Now, what about the answer? Was that correct? Richtig oder falsch? How is the correct answer? Yeah, no need to repeat the Z. What is the Z? Yeah, so I want you Cola, double A. So, ich möchte eine Cola. Ja? Okay, was möchten Sie, Maniarasi? Schon, was möchten Sie?
Ich möchte einen Eiskaffee.
Ah, ja, einen. Very carefully said, yes, correct. Und Alexander, was möchten Sie?
Ich möchte einen schicken Käse.
Käse, ja. Käse, top. Was sagt die Kellnerin? Kellnerin ist eine Waitress. Ja? What does she say? What does she ask the guests, for example? Was sagt der Gast? What does the guest say? Und was bestellen die Leute? What do they order? Ja? So try to answer these questions. And especially the first two ones are important that you also can recall that and use by your own. Because afterwards we are going to restaurants with menus. Okay, so you have to practice this. All right? So, let us try to get that video started.
Hallo, hallo. Hallo, hallo. Aus Berlin.
Hallo, ich bin Marco.
Ich bin Jessica.
Ich bin Daniel.
Hallo, ich bin Esther.
Ich bin Thomas.
Hallo, ich bin Rolli. Und heute wir.
Hallo, willkommen in Berlin. Ich bin Marco.
Hallo, ich bin Jessica.
Hallo, ich bin Daniel.
Hallo, ich bin Esther.
Hallo, ich bin Thomas.
Hallo, ich bin Miriam. Willkommen in Berlin.
Vorname? Vorname. Jessica. Jessica. Familienname? Familienname? König. König. Ich heiße Jessica König.
Ich heiße Daniel Augustin. Mein Vorname ist Daniel, mein Familienname ist Augustin. Daniel Augustin.
Ich heiße Daniel Augustin.
Mein Name ist Esther Walk.
Mein Name ist Thomas Lindel.
Mein Name ist Miriam Carsten.
Und wie heißt du?
Ich heiße Malte.
Ich heiße Judith.
Ich heiße Marc.
Ich heiße Björn Schwich.
Ich heiße Philipp Marx.
Wie heißen Sie?
Ich heiße Barbara Schmidt.
Wie heißen Sie?
Mein Name ist Ludwig Marx.
Mein Name ist Josephine Kumlior.
Mein Name ist Dietmar. Dietmar Schibrowski.
Und ich heiße Marco Walter. Hallo.
Hallo. Hallo.
Ah, Marco hat hellbraune Haare und grüne Augen.
Ich habe braune Haare und grüne Augen. Esther hat schwarze Haare und braune Augen.
Ich habe schwarze Haare
und braune Augen. Thomas hat blonde Haare und grüne Augen.
Ich habe blonde Haare und grüne Augen.
Wie alt bist du, Esther?
Ich bin 14 Jahre alt. Wie alt bist du, Miriam?
Ich bin erst 13.
Miriam.
Wie groß bist du, Marco?
Ich bin 1,60 Meter groß.
Ich bin 1,70 Meter.
Haha, ich bin sehr groß. Ich bin 1,90 Meter groß.
Daniel ist groß.
Und Thomas ist klein.
Daniel ist nicht groß.
Okay, ich bin nicht so groß.
Ja.
Und jetzt Rolli und Rita. Bist du nicht Rita?
Ja, ich bin Rita Weiß.
Hallo, mein Name ist Rolli. Rolli Schmidt.
Hallo, ich gehe jetzt auf den Jahrmarkt.
Ich auch.
Aber ich bin dick.
Du bist dick und ich bin auch dick.
Jetzt bin ich groß.
Ich habe rote Augen. Und grüne Haare.
Sieh mal, jetzt habe ich rosa Augen und weiße Haare. Ick, ick, ick.
Schau mal.
Oh, was ist das?
Hallo, was ist dein Name?
Nein. Gut, oder? Und jetzt? Philipp, was machst du gern?
Mit Lego spielen.
Ich spiele gerne Basketball.
Ich spiele gern Ball.
Ich fahre gerne Fahrrad.
Ich gehe gerne einkaufen.
Schlafen.
Und du, Thomas?
Ich fahre gern Fahrrad. Das ist mein Fahrrad. Es ist ein blaues Mountainbike. Es hat 18 Gänge. Ich fahre auf dem roten Fahrradweg. Und ich fahre gern im Park.
Daniel, was machst du gern?
Ich zeichne gern. Ich zeichne Comicfiguren. Sie alle haben Namen.
Wer ist das?
Das ist Oscar. Oscar ist ein Hund. Er hat lange Ohren. Große Augen. Und eine runde Nase.
Jessica, was machst du gern?
Ich gehe gerne einkaufen. Ich schaue mir die Schaufenster an.
Schön. Das probiere ich an.
Gut, ich kaufe es.
Marco, wen hast du gern?
Ich habe mein Meerschweinchen gern. Es heißt Schnuffi.
Wie alt ist es?
Schnuffi ist 2 Jahre alt. Es frisst Karotten und Salat. Es trinkt kein Wasser. Komm, Schnuffi, komm, komm. Schnuffi ist sehr lieb.
Und du, Miriam? Was machst du gern?
Ich spiele gerne mit meinem Hund. Das ist mein Hund Max. Er ist 6 Monate alt. Er ist halb Labrador und halb Rottweiler. Er isst fast alles. Wir spielen Ball. Wir gehen gern spazieren. Mein Hund ist mein bester Freund.
Esther, was machst du gern?
Ich mache gern Sport. Ich mache sehr gern Leichtathletik. Hochspringen. Hürdenlaufen. Auf die Plätze. Fertig. Los. Sprinten. Leichtathletik macht fit und macht Spaß.
Hallo, ich bin Rita. Wie heißt du? Ich bin 14. Wie alt? Bist du 4?
Bist du 4?
Bist du 7? Bist du 12?
Bist du 12?
Wie alt bist du?
Hallo aus Berlin, wie heißt du? Guten Tag Berlin, wie heißen Sie? Wie heißt du? Wie heißen Sie? Wie alt bist du? Und wie alt sind Sie?
Hallo, ich bin Rolli. Ich bin 15. Wie alt bist du? Bist du 10?
Bist du 10?
Bist du 13? Bist du 11?
Bist du 11?
Wie alt bist du?
Hallo aus Berlin. Wie heißt du? Guten Tag Berlin. Wie heißen Sie? Wie heißt du? Wie heißen Sie? Wie alt bist du? Und wie alt sind Sie? Hallo aus
Tschüss.
Berlin.
Tschüss.
Guten Tag Berlin. Tschüss. Wie heißen Sie?
Tschüss.
Wie heißt du?
Tschüss.
Tschüss.
We'll be right back.
Hallo, ich bin Rolli. Und heute Familie.
Oh, hallo, wie geht's? Heute fahren wir zur Oma. Das ist mein Vater. Das ist meine Mutter. Und hier ist meine Schwester Susanne mit Otto.
Matthias, komm!
Ich muss jetzt Schluss machen. Wir wollen
mich jetzt losfahren. Matthias ist mein Bruder. Okay. Immer am Telefon.
Dann mach's gut. Tschüss.
Das ist mein Großvater. Und meine Großmutter. Die Kinder kommen.
Na ja.
Hallo. Hallo. Na. Oma und Opa sind meine Großeltern.
Und Otto ist
hallo.
Da. Hallo.
Hallo.
Tag, hallo. Deckel. Hallo.
Huch. Alter, das ist ein dickes.
Meine Güte.
Hallo. Soll ich dir ab?
Hallo.
Abnehmen?
Hallo.
Ach, geht schon. Ach, danke schön. Ach.
Hast du Geschwister, Miriam?
Ja, ich habe eine Schwester und einen Bruder. Ich heiße Sarah und bin 12 Jahre alt.
Ich heiße Felix und ich bin 5 Jahre alt.
Marco. Hast du Geschwister?
Ja, ich habe eine Schwester. Sie heißt Alexandra.
Hallo, ich bin 11 Jahre alt.
Jessica, hast du Geschwister?
Ich habe einen Bruder. Er heißt Christian.
Hallo, ich bin 6 Jahre alt.
Esther, hast du Geschwister?
Ich habe 4 Brüder. Kevin, der ist jetzt in Amerika. Kenny, der ist 15 Jahre alt. Und Jerome und Yoshi.
Ich bin Jerome und bin 6 Jahre alt.
Ich bin Yoshi und bin 5 Jahre alt.
Ich habe keine Geschwister.
Wie alt bist du?
Ich bin 10 Jahre alt.
Ich bin 17 Jahre alt.
Ich bin 19.
Ich bin 12 Jahre alt.
Ich bin 8.
Wie alt sind Sie?
51 Jahre.
Wie alt sind Sie?
Ich bin 38 Jahre alt.
Ich bin 39 Jahre alt.
Miriam, hast du Haustiere?
Ja, ich habe einen Hund. Er heißt Max.
Hast du Haustiere, Marco?
Ja, ich habe ein Meerschweinchen. Und 2 Wellensittiche, Piepsi und Hansi.
Ich habe Fische.
Ich habe keine Haustiere. Ich gehe in den Zoo.
Das ist der Berliner Zoo.
Ah, die Giraffen. Vatergiraffe? Muttergiraffe? Oh, wie süß. Eine Babygiraffe. Und? Onkelgiraffe?
Ja, ich bin der Onkel.
Hallo.
Guten Morgen.
Schöne Augen.
Dankeschön.
Thank you.
Hallo, Tiger. Okay, Herr Tiger. Ah, die Gorillas. Vater Gorilla? Mutter Gorilla? Die zwei Babys? Und vielleicht die Tante.
Hallo, Baby.
Hau ab!
Was für Tiere magst du?
Ich mag Hamster und eine Katze.
Hunde.
Meerschweinchen.
Eine Katze.
Und Pferde.
Ratten.
Was für Tiere haben Sie gern?
Hunde.
Katzen und Hunde.
Katzen.
Einen Wellensittich.
Vögel und Katzen.
Am liebsten haben wir Hunde.
Und jetzt Rolli und Rita.
Hallo Rita.
Hallo Rolli.
Eine Schlange.
Sie heißt Zischer. Schau mal. Wie viel ist 3 plus 5, Zischer?
8. Fantastisch.
Und was macht 7 plus 3? Ja, richtig. Das macht 10.
Wie viel ist 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7?
Nein, Zischer.
Nein. Das ist mein Vater, aber das ist meine Oma. Das ist meine Schwester, aber das ist mein Bruder.
Rolli, bist du da?
Oh nein!
Muss gehen, Rolli. Tschüss!
Das ist Nade Todorovic. Nade wohnt nicht bei seinen Eltern.
Hallo, ich bin Nade, bin 16 Jahre alt. Hier ist meine Wohnung. Kommt rein. Das ist Steffi, das ist Sandra, wir wohnen zusammen. Mein Vater und meine Mutter wohnen nicht hier. Aber Thorsten und Carola kommen jeden Tag und sie helfen uns.
Was für Themen haben wir denn heute Abend?
Ja, wie ist das mit der Küche? Wer macht die Küche?
Ich habe die letztes Mal gemacht.
Und wer macht Bad? Jeden Mittwoch planen wir die Hausarbeit.
Ja, ist alles okay.
Die Hausarbeit machen wir allein.
Hausarbeit.
Wohnzimmer staubsaugen.
Wohnzimmer staubsaugen.
Kochen.
Kochen.
Müll runterbringen.
Müll runterbringen.
Bad sauber machen?
Bad sauber machen.
Das sieht nämlich so aus, das liegt nicht daran, dass die Gitarre verstimmt ist.
Fernsehen.
Und wir gucken uns jetzt ein Video an.
Fernsehen. Ist das Hausarbeit?
Sag doch mal was. Ey, die ist ja voll leise, Alter. Ich höre gerne Musik und tanze sehr gerne.
Zwei kleine Kätzchen, drei Wellensittiche, einen Hund, einen Fisch und eine große Katze.
In meiner Familie, in meiner Familie.
Ein Meerschweinchen, zwei kleine Kätzchen, drei Wellensittiche, einen Hund, einen Fisch und eine große Katze.
In meiner Familie.
Hey. Ich mag meine Großeltern sehr gern. Aber es ist hier so langweilig.
So, there are several situations, right? Which one? Can you recall? Can you recall the situations? It started with shopping, yeah, in the supermarket, right? Okay, so first, also die Situationen. First, einkaufen im Supermarkt. Im Supermarkt, Nummer 2. Hm, Cindy, what did you say? In what? McDonald's. Essen bei McDonald's. Ja, Nummer 3. Im Café. That is a café, yeah, traditional café. Essen im Café. Some more? No, that was so far, oder? Any? What? Alexander, what are you looking for? just thinking, okay. All right, these are the three major venues here, right? So, do you want to tell me regarding the questions about all of them? We can alter them. Or do you want straight away go to the restaurant only? I think... to make it easier for the moment, we go first to the coffee shop. To the coffee shop. So, was sagt die Kellnerin? Did you catch it?
Was machst du?
There was what?
Was
Also zu at question number one. Was sagt die Kellnerin? So, die Kellnerin sitzt. Was? We were coming from this question. Was möchten Sie? So when you transfer that to do, the informal one, how you do that? So it is not a real infinitive from this. Yeah, that is already conjunctive to be polite. So let's say the infinitive is something like this. Yeah? So how do you make out of that the form for do? Möchtest, yeah, because you have here still a T. Yeah, you remember like arbeiten. So you must have here was möchtest du. To whom does she say that? Nein, never ever. That would be even rude if she is doing that. Du is informal. At the end of the sem. So, du is for the kids, right? Here for the youngster, the boy. Okay? So, and for the lady, she will say?
Was möchten Sie?
Yeah, this one, right? So, was möchten Sie? Okay, then what do they answer? Only the item. But what do they say? How do they say it? Or does they take the menu and say here? Ich möchte, yeah, ich möchte. Simple and easy, right? Ich möchte, and then they say what they want. So both of them say that, or do they have alterations in the answers? Is that the same? Both of them say the same thing? Did you catch up there another phrase maybe? No? No, just asking. Because it's not only one, you can say it in different ways. No? Okay, I'll give you later. So, at number three, what do they order? Was bestellen die Leute? So die Mutter, das ist nicht die Mutter, ist die Auntie. Yeah? He is going shopping for her, so because he did a favor for her, she invited him for coffee shop. So, what does the Auntie order, die Tante? Was bestellt die Tante? Eistee, nein, nein. Das war kein Eistee, das war ein heißer Tee. Ein heißer Tee, a hot tea. So she did not extra mention that, but she wants some special ingredients there. What she wants the tea with? Yeah. So, ich möchte So now should I put back the picture just now? Do you know the gender still? Yeah, Lalita. Einen. You remember when I told you the genders of the nouns? I told you the E at the back is a 99% a symbol that it is feminine. But like tea and cafe, you have even two of them at the back, but it is masculine. Okay. So, einen Tee mit Zitrone. Mit, first we say normally the Zucker. Mit Zucker und Zitrone. Und, ja, it doesn't matter, but can use both. Ja, mit Zucker und Zitrone oder mit Zitrone und Zucker, it doesn't matter how you say. Okay, einen Tee mit Zucker und Zitrone. Und ja, so exactly. Ein Stück Kuchen oder ein Stück Torte. You can say both of that. Ein Stück means? Yeah, because you don't take the whole cake. Eh? So you get one piece, one slice of cake. Ein Stück. You know Frühstück? So früh means early. So it is the early piece in the day. Ah, that is the breakfast. And ein Stück is a slice here of cake, or one piece of cake. Okay, and the boy? Er bestellt einen? Einen Bananensplit. How do you do that in exams? How do you do that? Then you must better know a bit. It's coming soon, you know. On the 5th of January already, yeah? Not so much time. And then banana split. Anything else? Nein. So, anything else? How do we say that auf Deutsch? It appeared in the video at another place. What? Ah, we have Einkaufen im Supermarkt, McDonald's und im Café. So, Café already done, right? So, what about McDonald's und Supermarkt? Does there appear something, not anything else? Think. The price, yeah, price is not anything else. When the waiter or the sales girl is asking, do you want know something else? Some more? Don't remember anything? No? No? Have a look in your materials. There is something auf Seite 59. Ah, there are some phrases which you can use. I don't say everything. You chari also. What could it be? What can be suitable? Was darf ich bringen? What does that mean? What does that mean, Lily? Was darf ich bringen? Bringen is? Bring. So that is the waitress, right? Okay, what may I bring? What may I bring? Is she asking? Ja, ist das alles? That, who says that? Ja, die Kellnerin. That is additional. I must scratch that here inside. Ist das alles? Ist das alles? We are looking for something to say something else. That goes in this direction, yes? There's noch another one. It's a bit more polite. Do you find one? Miss U. Yes, exactly. Yes, or let us do it the formal one. Haben Sie? Haben Sie noch einen Wunsch? What does that mean? Haben Sie noch einen Wunsch? Ja, in a bit wider interpretation, yes, but a more direct translation. Do you have noch another wish? Wunsch is wish. Means would you like noch something else? Yeah, so that is what you can ask. So this, the first one, the first two you can use for the beginning, right? When the waitress comes to you and then she's asking you these questions. So when haben Sie noch einen Wunsch, would be already another round, right? Would be when she asks already for another order. And then at least, is that all? Is that everything? Some more? That would be the last one, right? Okay. And then how do you reply? Ich möchte is also, that is quite easy and simple, but there are also some more ways to say it. Wie bitte? When you grummel like this, I cannot understand. I'm so sorry, but Alfred. Ich nehme. Do you remember? Otherwise, we have to do it now. How that is conjugated, because that is a bit very strange conjugation. Do you remember how to do that? Ich nehme, du? Yeah, I heard it just now. Nimmst, yes. So I write it mal noch mal once here on top, because we need to have that in our conversation. Nehmen. Please complete your tables, yeah, your column, add on another one if you don't have it yet in your list. Ich nehme, du nimmst. Er, sie, es nimmt. Then the plural, wir nehmen. This you know already, but I no need to write. What about the plural? You know that. Okay, then, what about the plural? What do you know of irregular words? What is happening to them in plural? They are regular, right? So, then, can you continue? What is a normal conjugation? Ihr nehmt, sie nehmen, and the capital one, nehmen, yes. So this one here is abnormal, extra normal compared to that what we had before, because it has a change inside the stem. We don't have a H anymore. Not only a vowel change, we have even a consonant change. And that is so far the only one which we come across is them. Yeah? Don't worry about that. So we need to have that when we ask question. So can we mal just pronounce it, please? Ich nehme.
Ich nehme.
Du nimmst.
Du nimmst.
Er, sie, es nimmt.
Er, sie, es nimmt.
Wir nehmen.
Wir nehmen.
Ihr nehmt.
Ihr nehmt.
Sie nehmen.
Sie nehmen.
Sie nehmen.
Sie nehmen.
So at this example, it is also very nice to show you how the pronunciation changes when you have a double consonant of the same type. Here you have a double M, so you have a short vowel. Du nimmst. Er, sie, es nimmt. But here, wir nehmen, ihr nehmt. So we have a long A, a long vowel here, right? And the H is even pulling that noch longer. So here you have some pronunciation rules. All right, so coming back to our questions. So we have answered that so far. So do you remember what, I think Thomas is his name, what Thomas is going shopping there in the supermarket? Was kauft er? Sechs Äpfel. I don't have space here anymore. I take my this out here a bit. Sechs Äpfel. Also Äpfel. I take my the infinitive. Der Apfel. And then Äpfel. Äpfel has only umlaut in plural. No endings here. Ja? Der Apfel, die Äpfel. Was kauft er noch? Kartoffeln, ja. Die Kartoffeln, we take in plural, eh? One only, we never buy. Eh? Die Kartoffeln, that is your plural. Okay. Das Brot. Das Brot ist neutral. Then at the long counter, what did he buy there? So many types of sausages. Das ist die Wurst. Er kauft ein Stück Leberwurst. The, you can, that is a soft one, you can spread it on the roti, on the Brot. Ja, das ist Leberwurst. Okay. Ja. Anything else? Nein. Ist das alles?
Ja.
Okay. So now I ask you a very difficult question. Ah, see who can answer this. There have been two mistakes in this video. Which one? Hallo? What was wrong in that video? Can show you and you believe everything, eh? So uncritical. So, but with the money, there is not so, it's quite warm already there. Money is not a bad topic. No? Does it make click? No? When you have seen the McDonald's price list, you say, oh, you get a shock. Why?
Too expensive.
Expensive. What did you see there? What was written there? Yes, Daddy, that's it. Loud and clearly.
DM.
DM. DM means Deutsche Mark. Deutsche Mark. DM. And that movie, okay, it's not the latest one, but it's still up to date because you don't say anything else in the meanwhile. Yeah, we don't change the phrases and the words. So this is already over, überholt, also that is to be replaced, yeah? With Euro. This one, now you should have missed this symbol, right? That is Euro. Yeah. Do you remember the prices in McDonald's? Maybe one, roughly, so or so. Seven Deutsche Mark?
11.
You look on the highest, right? At the average, around 4, 5, maybe. 4 Deutsche Mark. 4 DM. Is how many euro? Nein. That would be nice. That would be very nice. 2 Euro, yes. 2 Euro. So 2 German Mark is 1 Euro. Ja? 2 Deutsche Mark is equivalent to 1 Euro. So when we in Germany got the new currency, what happened? Everything dropped half. The salary, bank account, suddenly only half of the amount. So, but what about the prices? They should also follow like that, but they didn't. Some of them, they just exchanged the currency here. They just do like that. So that means it became very expensive. Yeah, it became very expensive, and many people grumbled when we got the euro, because many of the normal daily grocery did not follow this price arrangement, and that was a big deal. Eh? A big deal. So nowadays Germans are halfway adjusted, yeah, as we have it already 12 years now, I think, or 11 years. So they got used to it, but they really suffered a lot with that. So maybe you have also heard about that they don't travel so much anymore, or they travel only inside Germany, not outside. So nowadays it come back to normal, ne? As you know, Germans like to travel, otherwise I also wouldn't be here, right? So they get adjusted to this. So another mistake. It's nothing to do with this kind of stuff. It has something to do with our language. Another mistake. Also, it's not a real mistake. It's something on spelling. Not in that song. It is before the song. When they ask the people. When they interview the people. What have you learned in the class here? How do you spell that?
I-S-S-T.
Ah. In the video it is written like this. Was isst du am liebsten? What is your favorite food? So, we have this no more. The sharp S is in the spelling reform. Yeah, when they did it, they have some new spelling rules. We changed it to ist. And that is what I was teaching you in this semester as well, right? So, I don't want to see this, yeah? Ah. Make sure that you write this one, okay? This one, yeah? Nice reminder, okay? Please, yeah? Remember this one? I don't want to see this. That is the old spelling, okay? Did I also tell you, Ma, how to check dictionaries? I mean, nowadays they should be all new in the shops, but when you want to be on the safe side, you just check one word only. It is Fluss. Fluss, the river. Yeah? That is der Fluss, the river. So when you have it written with a sharp S, with the SZ, it is an old one. So you can just check one word and you know if that is a correct spelling dictionary. Yeah? It should be this spelling. That is old. Okay? Yeah, so far so good. So now we want to use this a little bit for our own purposes. So after we have recorrect our video, we want to go now to restaurant, okay? So for this purpose, I have here real menus.
Can we order?
Yes, of course, you should even do so. So I must tell you something with this. This we have done once in, also like you, with a course like you, level 100, translated into German the menu from a real restaurant. Because there have been so many German guests, and you know when, maybe you know from the Star Cruise ship, those people there are mostly elderly people who are coming there with the big ships, so they don't speak much English. Yeah? So for that purpose, we say, okay, we help you to translate that into German, because it is a German restaurant. So then they were very grateful for that, invited us for food also, for lunch. Then this, unfortunately, it is no more in Penang. They moved to KL. There are many German restaurants in KL, so when you are there, you can practice German food, you can taste it. But here we also have Ingolf's Kneipe in Tanjung Bunga. You can also check that out. So this is called Schlemmerladen. That is something like a gourmet shop. Yeah, Laden is a shop, gourmet restaurant. And you have here Speisekarte. Don't ask for the menu, eh? You know, then you get already a set dish of the day. Das Menü has the same spelling as menu, but it means already the set dish of the day. So Speisekarte is the correct word for this menu. So when you ask, yeah, you will see it afterwards, I give it to you. You ask for Speisekarte. When the waiter maybe doesn't bring you automatically, then you ask for the Speisekarte. Okay? Bringen Sie mir bitte die Speisekarte. Then you will get the paper and not the set menu. Okay? So, there are many things inside, yeah? There are many, many things inside. So what I want you to figure out at the moment is not every single thing, then you sit until tomorrow there, sondern the titles here on top and maybe one sample of each. That is all, yeah? Not all of that, then you never finish, okay? So you have your dictionaries, online dictionaries. You have also here dictionaries. So you check also from every title, what is the meaning of the main courses there, and one sample for each.